Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed, and I'm getting into a game that I played way back in the day. Phoenix Wright games, Ace Attorney, baby. Got the trilogy on Switch. Yes. If you've never played this game, objection! Episode 1, The First Turnabout. It's been so long since I played this game. Let's go. Play The First Turnabout. Yeah, I'm so excited. I just got done giving up on Cuphead. So pumped to play this. Gasp! Gasp! Whoa! Statue with blood. Uh-oh, the killer. The killed. Uh-oh. Damn it! Why me? I can't get caught. Not like this. I've gotta find someone to pin this on. Uh-oh. Oh. Someone like him. I'll make it look like he did it. Okay, so we know who the killer is. Perfect. August 3rd, 9:47 a.m. District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 2. Boy, am I nervous. I'm talking to myself. Right! Oh, hiya, Chief. Whew, I'm glad I made it on time. Well, I have to say, Phoenix, I'm impressed. Not everyone takes on a murder trial right off the bat like this. It says a lot about you, and your client as well.
Thanks.
Actually...
Oh, so, whoops, that's Phoenix. Actually, it's because I owe him a favor.
A favor? You mean you knew the defendant before this case?
Yes. Actually, I kind of owe my current job to him. He's one of the reasons I became an attorney.
Well, that's news to me.
I want to help him out any way I can. I just really want to help him. I owe him that much.
It's over! My life, everything, it's all over!
Is that your client screaming over there? Yeah, it's him.
Death, despair! I'm gonna do it! I'm gonna die!
Sounds like he wants to die. Yeah.
Nick! Hey! Hey, Larry! Larry!
Dude, I'm so guilty. Tell him I'm guilty. Give me the death sentence. I'm okay. I ain't afraid to die.
What? What's wrong, Larry? Oh, it's all over. I am finished. I can't live in a world without her. I can't. Who took her away from me, Nick? Who did this? Oh, Nick, you gotta tell me who took my baby away.
The person responsible for your girlfriend's death. Newspapers say it was you. My name is Phoenix Wright. Here's the story. My first case is a fairly simple one. Woman dead, bleeding on the ground. A young woman was killed in her apartment. The guy they arrested was the unlucky sap dating her. Larry Butts. His brother, Seymour. My best friend since grade school. Our school had a saying, something smells. It's usually the butts. In the 23 years I've known him, it's usually been true. He has a knack for getting himself into trouble. One thing I can say, though, it's usually not his fault. He just has a terrible luck. But I know better than anyone he's a good guy at heart. That, and I owe him one, which is why I took the case to clear his name. And that's just what I'm going to do.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
August 3rd, 10 a.m. District Court, courtroom number 2. Uh-oh. Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Larry, brother of Seymour Butts.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
The defense is ready, Your Honor. Mr. Wright, this is your first trial, is it not?
Yes, Your Honor.
I'm a little nervous. Shouldn't say that out loud. Your conduct during this trial will decide the fate of your client. Murder is a serious charge. For your client's sake, I hope you can control your nerves.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Mr. Wright, given the circumstances, I think we should have a test to ascertain your readiness.
Yes, Your Honor.
Knees are sweaty.
Mom Spaghetti, I don't remember the other words. The test will consist of a few simple questions. Answer them clearly and concisely. Please state the name of the defendant in this case.
That'll be Mr. Larry, brother of Seymour Butts.
The defendant, easy, it's Larry Butts. That's my dog, that's my homie. It's me and Seymour. Larry, correct. Just keep your wits about you and you'll do fine. Next question. This is a murder trial. Tell me, what was the victim's name? Court record. Cindy. Let's see. It's... Wait. No. No way. I forgot. I'm drawing a total blank here. Phoenix! Are you absolutely sure you're up to this? You don't even know the victim's name? I do. It's Cindy. Well, the victim. Of course. Of course I know the victim's name. I forgot temporarily. I think I feel a migraine coming on. Look, the victim's name is listed in the court record like you just looked. Press the R button to check it at any time, okay? Remember to check it often. Do it for me, please. I'm begging you. Mr. Wright, who is the victim in this case? Cinderblock. Cindy Stone. The victim's name is Cindy Stone. What is Cindy Stone? Correct. Now you've won $1 million. Tell me what was the cause of death. She died because she was hit with a blunt object. She was struck once by a blunt object. Correct. You've answered all my questions. I see no reason why we shouldn't proceed. You seem much more relaxed, Mr. Wright. Good for you. Thank you, Your Honor. I don't feel relaxed. I peep myself. First, a question for the prosecution. Mr. Payne?
Yes, Your Honor.
As Mr. Wright just told us, the victim was struck with a blunt object. Would you explain to the court just what that object was?
The murder weapon was this statue of the Thinker. It was found lying on the floor next to the victim.
I see. The court accepts this into evidence. Statue added to the court record. Right. You should pay attention to any evidence added during the trial. That evidence is the only ammunition you have in court. Use the R button to check the court record frequently. Mr. Payne, the prosecution may call its first witness.
And the prosecution calls the defendant, Mr. Butts, to the stand.
Chief, what do I do now?
Pay attention. You don't want to miss any information that might help your client's case. You'll get your chance to respond to the prosecution later, so be ready. Let's just hope he doesn't say anything unfortunate.
Uh-oh. Larry, brother of Seymour Butts, gets excited easily. This could be bad. Okay.
Oh, he's calm, cool.
Ahem. Mr. Butts, is it not true that the victim had recently dumped you?
Hey, watch it, buddy.
We were great together. We were Romeo and Juliet, Cleopatra, and Mark Antony. No, you gotta relax. All of them died.
I wasn't dumped. She was just taking my phone calls. She wasn't taking my phone calls or seeing me, ever.
What is it you want?
Mr. Butts, what you describe is generally what we mean by dumped. In fact, she had completely abandoned you and was seeing other men. She had just returned from overseas with one of them the day before the murder.
What do you mean, one of them? Lies, all of it, lies. I don't believe a word of it.
Your Honor, the victim's passport. According to this, she was in Paris until the day before she died.
Passport edit. The victim apparently arrived home in Paris on the 7:30 day before the murder.
Indeed. She appears to have returned the day before the murder.
Dude, no way.
And the victim was a model, but did not have a large income. It appears that she had several, sugar daddies.
Daddies? Sugar?
Yes, older men who gave her money and gifts. She took their money and used it to support her lifestyle.
What?
We can clearly see what kind of a woman this Miss Stone was. Tell me, Mr. Brother of Seymour Butts, what do you think of her now?
Right. I don't think you want him to answer that question.
Yeah, Larry has a way of running
his mouth in all the wrong directions. Should I stop him from answering?
My client had no idea the victim was seeing other men. That question is irrelevant to this case.
Nick, what do you mean irrelevant? That cheating she-dog. I'm gonna die. I'm just gonna drop dead. Yeah, and when I meet her in the afterlife, I'm gonna get to the bottom of this. Let's continue with the trial, shall we?
I believe the accused's motives is clear to everyone.
Yes, quite. Oh, dope. This looks great.
Next question. You went to the victim's apartment on the day of the murder, did you not? Well, did you or did you not?
Well, I mean, yeah, and maybe I did, maybe I didn't. Uh-oh. He definitely went. What do I do? Have him answer honestly. I know, I'll send him a signal. Tell the truth. Yeah, I was there. I went. Yeah, I went. I did it. Order. Well, Mr. Butts. Everybody relax.
She wasn't home, man, so I, like, didn't see her.
What?
Your Honor, the defendant is lying.
Lying?
The prosecution would like to call a witness who can prove Mr. Butts is lying.
Well, that simplifies matters. Who is your witness?
The man who found the victim's body just before making the gruesome discovery. He saw the defendant fleeing the scene of the crime.
Lies.
Oh, you're lying on me.
Order in the court. Mr. Payne, the prosecution may call its witness.
Yes, Your Honor.
This is bad. I need to have a return.
On the day of the murder, my witness was selling newspapers at the victim's building. Please bring Mr. Frank Sawhit to the stand.
Frank Sawhit.
Oh, you did it.
He was selling newspapers? Mr. Sawhit, you sell newspaper subscriptions, is that correct?
Oh, yes. Newspapers, yes. Mr. Sawhit, you may proceed with your testimony. Please tell the court what you saw on the day of the murder. Witness testimony, here we go. This is the witness's account. I was going door to door selling subscriptions when I saw a man fleeing an apartment. I thought he must be in a hurry because he left the door half open behind him. Thinking it strange, I looked inside the apartment. Then I saw her lying there, a woman, not moving, dead. I quailed in fright and found myself unable to go inside. I thought to call the police immediately. However, the phone in her apartment wasn't working. I went to a nearby park and found a public phone. I remember the time exactly. It was 1 p.m. The man who ran was without a doubt the defendant sitting right over there.
Larry, why didn't you tell the truth?
I can't defend you against a testimony like that. Yes, you can. Incidentally, why wasn't the phone in the victim's apartment working?
Your Honor, at the time of the murder, there was a blackout in the building.
Aren't phones supposed to work during a blackout?
Yes, Your Honor. However, some cordless phones do not function normally. The phone that Mr. Sawhit used was one of those. Your Honor, I have a record of the blackout for your perusal.
Electricity to Mr. Stone's building was out from noon to 6 p.m. on the day of the crime. Okay. His 1 o'clock stands.
Now, Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor.
You may begin your cross-examination.
Cross-examination, Your Honor? All right, Wright, this is it. The real deal.
What exactly am I supposed to do?
Why, you exposed the lies in the testimony the witness just gave. Lies? What? He was lying? Your client is innocent, right? Then that witness must have lied in his testimony. Get his ass! How do I prove he's not?
You hold the key. It's in the evidence. Compare the witness's testimony to the evidence at hand. There's bound to be a contradiction in there. First, find the contradictions between the court record and the witness's testimony. Then, once you've found the contradicting evidence, present it and rub it in the witness's face.
Okay.
Open the court record with the R button, then point out the contradictions in the testimony.
Cross-examination.
I was going to the door selling subscriptions when I saw a man fleeing an apartment. Okay. Time of death. It was between 4 and 5 p.m.
got you. Okay, dope. Okay, go, strangled in the apartment. I start lying there, moving. Bam, quailed. Tell me you remember what time it was. I'm checking my phone. Remember the time exactly, it was 1 p.m. Uh-oh. City's autopsy report says the time of death was 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. Presented.
Objection!
You found the body at 1 p.m.? You sure?
Yes, it was 1 p.m. for certain.
Uh-oh. Frankly, I find that hard to believe. Your statement directly contradicts the autopsy report. The autopsy notes the time of death at sometime after 4 p.m. Lying! There was nobody to, no body to find at 1 p.m. Ha! How do you explain this 3-hour gap, huh?
This is trivial. The witness merely forgot the time.
After his testimony, I find that hard to believe. Mr. Sawit, why were you so certain that you found the body at 1 p.m.?
That's a really good question.
Great job, Wright. Way to put him on the spot. That's all you have to do. Point out contradictions. Lies always beget more lies. See through one, and their whole story falls apart. Ha ha ha.
Wait, I remember now.
Would you care to give your testimony again?
Tell me again. Say something to me again. Time of discovery, okay?
You see, when I found the body, I heard the time. There was a voice saying the time. It was probably coming from the television. Oh, but it was 3 hours off, wasn't it? I guess the victim must have been watching a video or of a taped program. That's why I thought it was 1 p.m. Terribly sorry about the misunderstanding.
Oh, I already know. I see. You heard a voice saying the time on a taped program. Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine the witness.
Wright, you know what to do. I got this one. I got it. Do you guys know?
This is my Blue's Clues. Where is the evidence? Okay, I heard the time. There was a voice saying it, probably coming from the television.
Oh, but excuse me, because if the body was found between what? 4 and 5, and the blackout was between noon and 6, yo ass is lying. Objection!
Hold it right there.
The prosecution has said there was a blackout at the time of the discovery.
And this record proves it.
Ooh, saw it, is wiggling.
You couldn't have heard a television or a video.
The defense has a point. Do you have an explanation for this, Mr. Sawit?
No, I find it quite puzzling myself, quite.
Wait, I remember now.
Mr. Sawit? The court would prefer to hear an accurate testimony from the very beginning. These constant corrections are harming your credibility. That's the judge. That, and you seem rather distraught.
My apologies, Your Honor. It must have been the shock of finding the body.
Very well, Mr. Sawit. Let's hear your testimony once more, please.
Oh, you're going down. You're going down. Hearing the time.
Actually, I didn't hear the time. I saw it. There was a table clock in the apartment, wasn't there? Yeah, the murder weapon. The killer used it to hit the victim. That must have been what I saw.
You saw a clock? I guess that would explain it. The defense may cross-examine the witness.
Gladly.
Let's go. Let's see. Hearing the time?
Actually, I didn't hear the time. I saw it.
There's a table clock in the apartment. A table clock? Oh, but excuse me, sir. A table clock is what the victim was hit with? That's what you're saying?
Looks to me like the victim was hit with a statue of the thinker, not a clock. So you know what that means. 3, 2, 1. Objection!
Wait just one damn minute.
The murder weapon wasn't a clock. It was his statue. Now, how is this supposed to be a clock? Tell me that. Riddle me this. Mr. Pink Suit Man telling newspapers saying it's 1 o'clock when you know damn well my friend didn't do this. What? You with your objections and your evidence, just who do you think you are? Just answer the question, Mr. Saw It. Hey, I saw her there, okay? That's a clock.
Your Honor, if I may.
Yes, Mr. Payne?
As the witness stated, this statue is indeed a clock. The neck is a switch. You just tilt it and it says the time out loud.
As it doesn't look like a clock, I submitted it as a statue. My apologies.
I see. So the murder weapon was a table clock after all. Well, Mr. Wright, it appears that the witness's testimony was correct. This is a clock. Do you have any problems with his testimony now?
Hell yes I do!
Your Honor, there's a gaping hole in the witness's testimony. The only way he could have known the weapon was a clock is to hold it in his hand, exactly, and the only way that the switch would have gone off is if he swung on somebody. Yet the witness testified that he never entered the apartment. Ooh! Clearly a contradiction.
Indeed.
The witness knew it was a clock because he... You're lying. You were inside the apartment on the day of the murder.
Ah, oh yeah? Prove it. Prove I went in there.
I'll do better than that. I can prove you were the one who killed her.
You struck her with the clock and the shock of the blow triggered the clock's voice. That was the sound you heard.
Order in the court. Intriguing. Please continue, Mr. Wright.
Yes, Your Honor. Mr. Saw It, the sound must have left quite an impression on you.
Understandable, since the murder weapon spoke just as you hit the victim.
The voice was burned into your mind. That's why you were so certain about the time.
But what's the meaning of this? This is all baseless conjecture.
Baseless? Just look at the witness's face.
Would the witness care to elaborate? Did you strike the victim with the clock?
I never. Look, I saw.
Oh, he threw his toupee. Disgusting.
Shut up. I hate you. It was him, I tell you. I saw him. He killed her, and he should burn, give him death.
Nah, you lying.
Order in the court, I say.
Your Honor, a moment, please. There isn't a shred of evidence supporting the defense's claims.
Mr. Wright, Your Honor, you claim the sound the witness heard came from the clock. Do you have any evidence?
Okay, she's writing on this. I'd better think it through carefully, okay?
Your Honor, the sound Mr. Saw It heard was definitely this clock. A fact which is clear if you simply try sounding the clock. Let's sound the clock now, here in this court.
Your Honor, may I have the clock?
I ask the court to listen very carefully. Because if it was like 4 and he hit her with it and said 1, okay. We should hear it say 1 o'clock. Alarm clock, it beeped. I think it's 8:25.
And it's certainly a strange way to announce the time.
Well, he is the thinker, after all.
So we've heard the clock. What are your conclusions, Mr. Wright?
Mr. Payne, can you tell me what time it is now?
It's 11:25. Which is 3 hours before! Yeah. So not 1 o'clock, 3 hours before.
As you can see, this clock is exactly 3 hours slow. Precisely the discrepancy between what Mr. Saw It heard and the actual time of death.
So Mr. Saw It, try to talk your way out of this one.
Ha! 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 You forgot one thing.
Uh-oh, what's he talking about?
Well, it may seem like that clock is running 3 hours slow. It proves nothing. How do you know it was running 3 hours slow on the day of the murder? If you can't prove that, you don't have a case.
He's
right. How am I going to prove that? Batteries! Damn it, I was so close.
Mr. Wright, it seems you lack the critical evidence to support your claim.
Yes, Your Honor.
This means I cannot let you indict the witness. Unfortunately, this ends the cross-examination of Mr. Frank Saw.
I come all the way down here to testify, and look what happens. You treat me like a criminal! A criminal! You lawyers are all slime!
It's afflicted upon horse trauma. It's heavy.
Okay. I almost had him.
Sorry, Larry. I failed you. There's nothing I can do about it now.
Really? Not so fast, Mr. Saw. There we go. There we go, Mia speaking up. Mia, I mean, Chief, listen up, right? Don't throw this one away. Not like this. Think. But, Chief, it's over. The batteries. I can't prove the clock was slow the day of the murder. Nobody can prove that. Well, yes. That doesn't mean you can't still win. Try thinking outside of the box. Don't waste time doubting the facts. Assume the clock was 3 hours slow and think it through. Ask yourself, why was the clock 3 hours slow? Figure out the reason and you'll have your proof. Right, right? Can you think of a reason as to why the clock would be 3 hours slow?
Yes.
Wait! Maybe I can prove it. You must have evidence somewhere that can prove it, right? Find it and let him have it.
Well, Mr. Wright, you say the clock was already running slow on the day of the murder. Have you found evidence to support this claim?
Of course. There's a piece of evidence in the court record that can prove my claim beyond a doubt. Huh, tough words. Let's see you pull this one off.
Let's see the evidence that proves why the clock was running slow.
Electricity was out, but it was on batteries.
Take that! Take that! Take that! The victim had just recently returned from abroad the day before the murder.
Okay, where are we going with this?
As we all know, the time difference between here and Paris is 9 hours. When it's 4 p.m. here, it's 1 a.m. the next day there. The clock wasn't 3 hours fast.
Oh!
The clock wasn't 3 hours slow, it was 9 hours fast! The victim had reset her clock since returning home. That's why the time you heard when you struck her in her apartment was wrong. Proof enough for you, Mr. Sart, or should I say, Mr. Did It! Got you.
I don't know the time differences between Paris and wherever they are. He foamed at the mouth and died. Oh, passed out. He's not even there anymore. Okay. Let's go.
Order, order, I say!
Got you.
Well, this case has certainly turned out differently than we all expected. Mr. Payne, your witness?
He was arrested and has been taken away, Your Honor.
Very well. Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor.
I have to say, I'm impressed. I don't think I've ever seen someone complete a defense so quickly and find the true culprit at the same time.
Thank you, Your Honor.
At this point, this is only a formality, but this court finds the defendant, Mr. Larry Butts, not guilty. Go home to your brother Seymour. Seymour Butts. And with that, this court is adjourned.
Winner! Yeah! Turns out that Frank Saw It was a common burglar. He posed as a newspaper salesman to check and see when people were out of the house. Ah, that day. When Larry went to her apartment, the victim wasn't home. After he left, Mr. Saw It let himself in to do his dirty work. While he was searching her place, the victim returned. Flustered, Mr. Sawt grabbed the nearest blunt object he could find.
Senseless.
August 3rd, 2:32 p.m., District Court.
Whew. Still can't believe we won. Right, good job in there. Congratulations.
Thanks, Chief. I owe it all to you.
Not at all. No, not at all. You fought your own battles in there, bruh. It's been a while since I've seen a trial and on such a satisfying note.
I've never seen the chief looking this happy. If she's this glad, imagine how Larry must feel.
My life is over. Larry, you're supposed to be happy. What's wrong now? Oh, Nick,
Don't worry about me. I'll be dead and gone soon. Good. Wait. No. No. I mean bad. 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 Larry, you're innocent. The case is closed. But my Cindy Wendy's gone, man. Gone forever.
Larry, she was a... Nah. Never mind. I'm not gonna drop that knowledge on him. Can't save her.
Congratulations, Harry.
Larry.
Harry. Yes, you. I can practically see the headlines now. Harry Butts. Innocent.
Heh.
Thanks. I really owe you one. I won't forget this, ever. Let's celebrate. Dinner, movie, my treat. Oh no, I couldn't.
Hey, I was the one who got you off the hook.
Oh hey! Here, take this. It's a present. A present for me? Wait, wasn't this the evidence that... Actually, I made this clock for her. I made one for her and one for me.
Really? You? You made this?
Well, thank you. I'll keep it as a memento.
Yo, Nick!
Can you believe it? I was so into that chick. And she was just playing me for a fool. Don't that make you want to just cry?
Larry.
Are you so sure? Excuse me? I think she thought quite a lot of you in her own way.
Nah, you don't gotta sympathize with me. It's okay.
Oh, I'm not just sympathizing, really. Isn't that right, right? Don't you have something to show your friend? Something that proves how she felt about him?
Huh? Oh, yeah. Right. What is she talking about? She kept it.
Take that!
Check this out, Larry. Proof positive you weren't just some chump to her.
Huh? What about that clock?
This is the clock you made for her, Larry. She took it with her when she traveled. Whatever, she probably just needed a clock. That's all.
You think so? It's a pretty heavy clock to take traveling.
Well, make of it what you will.
Hey, Nick. I'm glad I asked you to be my lawyer. Really, I am. Thanks.
Hope that made him feel a little better.
Ah, my friend. Right? I hope you see the importance of evidence now. Also, hopefully you realize things change depending on how you look at them. People, too. We never really know if our clients are guilty or innocent. All we can do is believe in them. And in order to believe in them, you have to believe in yourself. Right? Listen, learn, grow strong. Never let go of what you believe in. Never. Well, I think our work here is done. Shall we be off?
Yeah, I guess so.
Say, how about dinner? On me. We'll drink a toast to innocent butts.
Yeah!
Oh, speaking of Harry, you were saying part of why you became a lawyer was because of him.
Yeah, part at least.
You'll have to tell me more about it sometime. Maybe over drinks?
Oh, me, you're trying to get it! So my first trial came to a close. Larry slapped me on the back and said, "Gee, Nick, it's good to have friends. But I'm pretty sure he's not gonna pay us. Unless you count the clock he gave me." I didn't know it then, but that clock was soon going to be at the center of another incident. My promise to tell the chief about me and Larry would be one promise I wouldn't be able to keep. The end. Wow. That's the first chapter of Phoenix Wright, Attorney at Law. All right, well, next time. No. Turnabout Sisters, next time. No. We're not doing that. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Let us know if you like this. I'll film another one. I'll probably film like 2 or 3 more. If you guys are into it, then I'll continue with the trilogy. If not, okay. If you like the voices, let me know. If you don't like the voices, let me know. Tell me what you like. Tell me what you don't like. And we'll adjust. The adjustment will probably come around episode 4 or 5. So, you know. Phoenix Wright. Let's go. Till next time. Keep it tight. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da